Last year, Jako Productions and the George Odlum Foundation invited all 26 of St. Lucia's secondary schools to compete in a national George Odlum essay competition, in which students were required to enter essays of 1,000 to 1,200 words on the greatness of George Odlum. The essay contest, together with Dr. Anderson Reynolds' forthcoming book, They Called Him Brother George, Portrait of a Caribbean Politician, is part of an effort to continue celebrating and honoring the life of George Odlum.
It is part of honoring George Odlum and, by example, our other national heroes, encouraging students to read more, encouraging a love of history, and also to help forge national identity and a sense of nationhood. And it aligns with the Prime Minister's pledge to teach history throughout our school system.
The essays of three female students impressed the judges the most and have made the shortlist. The students are Davy and Alexander of the Beanfield Comprehensive Secondary School, Tia Maria Alexander of the Bonte Preparatory High School, and C. Ann Alfred of the Viewfort Comprehensive Secondary School. All three admit that the contest has been a learning experience, allowing them to acquire knowledge of a man who is regarded as a colossal Caribbean leader, one of the region's best orators, and one of its most charismatic and controversial politicians.
When I heard who it was on, I was interested because I didn't know much about him, and I wanted to learn more, especially because I know he was a political figure, and I love politics. I love politics. I always joke my classmates and say I'll be the first female prime minister. So I was interested in knowing more about him.
I had little knowledge about George Odlum, but when my English A teacher brought him up saying that we had an essay to do, I didn't really have the enthusiasm to do it. But as I researched about him more, I got really interested.
I didn't know of his name. I knew of the buildings that were in his namesake, but my information about George Odlum was surface level at most. I got to research on his political achievements, the achievements he made in St. Lucia, the Caribbean as a whole, his education, so we're very thankful for that.
The essays of the three shortlisted contestants have been published on the Jako Productions website and are expected to be published in the national newspapers. The winner of the essay competition will be announced and awards presented at the official launching of They Called Him Brother George book in February 2023. Moreover, the winner will be invited to read her winning essay at the book launch.
The judges and myself were quite pleased with the quality of the essays, the top final, the shortlisted essays. We were very pleased with the quality of it. And people who have read it are quite impressed. So I think it was a very commendable effort on the part of the students.
The top placed contestants of the George Odlum essay contest will receive cash prizes as well as laptops, tablets, and books depicting St. Lucian history and culture. All contestants and their schools will receive a copy of They Called Him Brother George, Portrait of Caribbean Politician. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.